breaking the news that's already broken. It's time for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
Scientists have taken DNA from a woolly mammoth and made a big lab-grown meatball from it. While scientists don't know what it tastes like, they know it'd be way better than a vegan meatball. A Dutch sperm donor who has fathered 550 children has been sued. The man is defending himself by saying his idol is Nick Cannon. Jamie Foxx serenaded Quentin Tarantino for his birthday. If you're worried that'll give Quentin a big head, too late.
Prospector ruins everything, even the news. Tune in tomorrow for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
Prospector prank call on Rock 107. Today we're calling a woman named Rhonda and talking about her ugly car. Her husband reached out and said she's got a horrible car. It's terrible. She always parks it in the same place and he wanted me to prank her about how ugly it is. It's another Prospector prank call on Rock 107.
Hello.
Yeah, hi. Is this Rhonda?
Yes, it is.
Rhonda, my name is Rick Wintermantle. I live at 22 Street.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the red house, four houses down from you.
Okay.
Okay, I have a quick question. It's just a small favor to ask, if you don't mind. Do you drive the...
Yeah, no problem.
Do you drive the Honda Civic, the gray Honda Civic?
Yes, I do.
Okay. We just put in a brand new lawn and new landscaping on the front of the house, and I noticed that most days you park your car right in front of my house.
Yes.
Okay. Would it be all right if you didn't park there until you got a different car? And I hate to ask you, and I hate to even call to bother you with it, but it's just that we got the house done, and it looks so good.
What? It's a public street. You can park anywhere.
No, I understand that. And I'm sure there's other spaces on the street. If you could park your car in one of those other spaces somewhere else on the street and just not park it in front of our house.
No, that's not okay.
Really?
You can't tell me where to park.
I'm not telling you where to park. I'm asking. It's different, okay? If I could tell you where to park, I'd say park it two blocks away. I don't even want to see the car.
No, I'm not doing that.
Okay.
No, this is ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous. Look, I just spent money.
Okay, that's your problem.
It is my problem, and that's why I'm calling. I'm not telling you where to park.
Then move. I don't know.
I'm supposed to move? I'm going to move my whole house so that you can park right where you want? Really?
Yes.
You honestly want me? You could park anywhere else on the street, but you got to park that big tin can ugly thing in front of my house?
Every day in front of your house.
Really?
Are you serious?
Okay, look, don't leave it there too long because it might get towed. You never know.
By who? And if you tow my damn car, you're going to pay for it.
Well, to be honest, you could at least get a better car.
A better car? What? Okay, tell me what's so bad about my car.
Well, first of all, what year is it? It's old, right? I mean, it looks...
It's a 2006.
Yeah, it's a show.
You know what? I'm going to have my husband come and
speak
with you.
Oh, really?
You can't tell me where
to park. So all I did was ask you if you'd not park in front of my house. I didn't tell you.
Okay, well, I'm telling you, I'm not parking
anywhere. It's the only space you can park in?
Yes, it's the only space that's available, yes.
No, it's not. Look, there are plenty of spaces where you can park that box.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm not moving my car, and if you get my car towed, go ahead and tell him I dare you to tow my car.
Just listen to me, okay?
Listen.
We spent a good amount of money making our house look very nice.
Well, you know what?
And now it's framed in front of it by your big, ugly car.
You know what? I am parking my car every day there from now on.
I'm just going to pour a bunch of nails on the street right there, so be careful.
You know what? And then I'm going to call the cops because now you're defacing my car.
I'm not doing anything. Don't drive over nails, right? What do you do?
You know what?
You call the cops every time you get a nail in your tire, a flat tire?
I'm having this conversation with you because you fixed up your house. You're going to call me and tell me I can't park.
You want to know something?
Car.
I don't want to hear anything. I can't believe.
You know what?
I can't believe you even think this is real.
Is this not real?
No, it's a prank call. It's a Prospector prank call.
You know what? You are so lucky because I was like 2.2 seconds from coming and knocking at your door.
Rhonda, your husband actually gave us your number.
Oh, my God. I'm going to kill him. I can't. Oh, my God. When he comes home,
No. Don't kill him. It's all good.
As a matter of fact, he's sleeping in that parking spot tonight. I can't believe this.
Who doesn't love spring? Good morning. I'm Rock 107's Prospector. I mean, spring is a great time of year. Things are renewing. Life is beginning again in many things. But there are some bad things about spring. I'll tell you the number one bad thing about spring here in Northeast PA. You probably already know it. You probably hit one on the way in already. Potholes. Oh, potholes are horrible. Who likes potholes? Well, people who own tire and wheel companies. Other than that, nobody. But I have written another poorly sung parody for potholes. How about that alliteration? Yeah, here it is. You didn't ask for it. You probably don't want it, but you're going to get it. It's Prospector's poorly sung parody to the tune of Golden Earring's Radar Love. It's Pothole Love. Another poorly sung parody from me, Prospector, on Rock 107. I've been driving all day. My car's taking a beating. There's holes in the road that wreck my wheels. I'm making a call saying I need new gear. Gonna cost me $1,000 to fix this here. When I am dodging every hole in the road, weaving around like a drunk on his way home, might need an ATV. This here's the thing they call pothole love. We need to fix every road. Pothole love. I know, I'm terrible at singing. It's not going to stop me.
Life's pretty tough right now. There's plenty of bad news, but it's not all bad. It's time for the brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
A no-kill animal shelter in Kansas City posted a six-minute video this month to get more cats adopted, and it worked really well. They wrote down different traits on scrap paper like loves to cuddle, great with other cats, then had employees pick them from a hat and tell people which cat had that trait. The video racked up 400,000 likes this month, and now almost all the cats featured in it have been adopted out.
Thanks. We needed that. The brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107. What's a yambag? A fool, an idiot, a blockhead, a dunce, or an ignoramus. You know, a dullard, simpleton, or a clot, nitwit, dipstick, pea brain, mouth breather, or cretin.
It's now time to announce the winner of Prospector's Yambag of the Day, as decided by you at rock107.com.
Here are the nominees. Nominee number one.
A lot of suitcases look the same, so you might have stood at a baggage claim and worried someone may get your bag by mistake. But you know, someone could also take it on purpose. A man was arrested after he stole a suitcase from a baggage claim in Atlanta and then was found because the owner of the bag had an AirTag tracking device in the suitcase. That guy had been waiting for his bag to show up and it never did. So he looked at the AirTag app and realized it had been taken. He contacted security, but apparently they weren't able to do much. So over the next day, he followed the tracking information himself, then confronted the thief with a police officer in tow. At the time, the thief was wearing his shirt and jeans. The owner got all his stuff back, and the thief was charged with theft, unlawful removal of baggage, and trespassing. It sounds like he just walked into the airport and took it, but it's unclear exactly what went down. For what it's worth, the airport claims there are officers there to prevent people from taking bags that aren't theirs. But if you fly regularly, you know that no one's really closely monitoring who's taking what at baggage claim.
Nominee number two.
As far as crimes go, no one saw this one coming. Well, maybe the cops did, but only because this clown hit two of the same type of businesses in the same area. So cops set up on a nearby third business. 40-year-old Jesse Alexandra was arrested in California after allegedly burglarizing optometry businesses and stealing bags full of glasses. He was successful at the first two locations, but police saw him break the window of a third business and chased him down. They found the stolen glasses in his SUV, which was parked in a parking lot nearby. No word on whether or not he thinks he was framed or what he planned to do with the stolen eyewear.
And the winner is...
the guy who stole someone's suitcase at baggage claim and was found wearing their clothes. You are the Yambag of the Day, and we'll move on to Friday's Yambag of the Week competition. Keep it here for all the nominees for Prospector's Yambag of the Week, right here on Rock 107.
Thanks for listening to Prospector's Prime Cuts Podcast. Be sure to catch us live weekdays from 5:30 to 10 a.m. on Rock 107 or online at rock107.com or the Rock 107 app, a free download for your Android or iPhone. Subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher Radio, or wherever you get your podcasts so you never miss Prospector's Prime Cuts.